Good morning, my dear students. Let us continue our class. Today we will discuss about heterotrophic nutrition. Before we discuss about today's topic, let us recall what we did in our previous class, that is autotrophic nutrition. When I say autotrophic nutrition, it means self-nutrition. Those organisms which can make their own food. They are known as autotrophic, and they make their own food with the help of water, air, and sunlight. This shows that they are self-dependent. There are two types of autotrophs, that is photoautotrophs and chemoautotrophs. Photoautotrophs are those, or let's say in this category of plants, the plants perform the process of photosynthesis, so that they can prepare their food. And then chemoautotrophs. Chemo means chemicals. This means that this category of plant take the help of chemicals to prepare their food. Now, let us discuss today's topic, that is heterotrophic nutrition. What is heterotrophic nutrition? Heterotrophic nutrition means some plants, they depend on other plants or animals for their food. Why do they depend on others for their food? Maybe because they do not have chlorophyll. Maybe because they cannot perform photosynthesis. This shows that they cannot prepare their own food. In this case, it shows that they lack chlorophyll, right? Chlorophyll is a green pigment that is present in the leaf. And we also know that this chlorophyll plays an important role in the process of photosynthesis, right? So, heterotrophic or heterotrophs, since they lack chlorophyll, they cannot perform photosynthesis. That is why they depend on other plants or animals for their survival. Let us discuss the mode of nutrition. We have four modes of nutrition, that is parasites, insectivorous, saprotrophs, and symbiosis. Now, let us discuss the first one, that is parasites or parasitic plants. So when I say parasites or parasitic plants, it means that these plants take their nutrients from another living plant. So these plants, they live on another plant for their survival. The best example is worm. They live inside the human body, right? And then there are a lot of tiny worms that live inside our body. So they obtain food and nutrition from our body. Okay. So there are plants that live on other plants and obtain their nutrition from that plant. Okay. So such plants that live on other plants for their survival are called parasites. And the plant on which they depend, okay, the plant on which they depend for their food or for their survival is known as or is called as the host. Next, we have insectivorous. Insectivorous plant or insectivorous. So if we look at the name, insectivorous, by looking the name, we can know that these plants, they feed on insects. In this case, what happened is that the leaves are modified, okay? The leaves are modified into structure. Aling to zak tabang lima na umintin. Ako mahugan cha ho alo wale. Husi ho alien ale. Akup loy chal na. If you look at the name insectivorous, by the name itself, we can know that these plants, they feed on insects, right? In this case, the leaves are modified into structures. Okay, the leaves are modified to trap insects, that help to trap insects. Okay, the best example is pitcher plant. I hope you all have seen this pitcher plant. Whenever an insect comes near this pitcher plant, and once the insect falls into the pitcher, as soon as the insect falls, the lid closes, okay? The lid closes and and the insects, they are digested inside. Next, we have saprotrophs or saprotrophs nutrition. So what does the word sapro mean? Sapro means anything dead or decay, okay? Sapro means anything dead or decay. So these organisms, they obtain their food. They obtain their food from dead and decaying organisms. Those plants that have saprotrophic mode of nutrition, okay? Those plants that have this saprotrophic mode of nutrition, they are called as saprotrophs. And they feed on dead plants. They feed on dead plants or animals. The best example, or let's say the common example that we have is mushroom. Pahna. Pahu. They feed on dead plants, okay? Dead plants or animals. Symbiosis. Symbiosis means an association. It is an association between two or more species where one or both are mutually benefited. The best example we can discuss is a bee and a flower. In this case, there is a symbiotic relationship between a bee and a flower. The bee is obtaining pollen from the flower, right? So this is how bee is benefited from the flower. So the flower is again pollinated by this bee. So this is symbiosis. Assignment. What do you understand by parasitic plants? What is an insectivorous plant? What is symbiosis? Why do heterotrophs depend on other organisms? Thank you.